A fiddler on the roof. Sounds crazy, no? But here in our little village of Anatevka, you might say every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous?
My name is Joe Picard.
My name is Iris Soroka.
I'm Cherise.
My name is Megan Cooper.
My name is Spiro Koutsis.
I'm Laura Sheen.
My name is Alden Etra.
I am Tara Heamy.
And for the purposes of the Fiddler on the Roof production coming up with our spring play, I am the musical director. The musical director works with the stage director, which is Ms. Etra, and the choreographer, and the orchestra director. And my job is to put together the musical from everything that takes place on the stage that's not spoken. So if it's sung or played, I'm kind of crafting that.
Was merrily content to be as I was, where I was. Close to the people who are close to me, here in the home I love.
All right! This was my dream.
I'm Laura Sheen, and I'm the director.
Sebastian, can you sound a bit more exasperated? Because you're very stressed with recitals, and then all of a sudden Model comes in, and he's talking, and you really don't want to be with him right now. So a little bit more annoying. Other than that, good job.
I'm really impressed with how talented the whole cast is. They're all doing a really good job with the musical.
By Sarah.
Yeah, from a Sarah, that first wife of his. She was a bitter woman. May she rest in peace.
My first impressions were that I fit the role pretty well since because of my background, and I thought it would be a really fun thing to do, so.
L'chaim.
Now children, I will tell you the story from the Bible of Laban and Jacob. And
no, you won't. Not in school, you upset.
The biggest issue is just the fact that we are a very big group.
A cast this huge is hard to handle for anybody.
Much bigger cast, and it's so much more overwhelming.
With such a big cast. Like, every other production I've had has, the cast wasn't even half the size. It's crazy how big this is.
It is an absolutely ginormous cast, but I think they'll be able to pull it off. It's gonna be hard, but they'll make it work.
It's only been like a couple weeks, and it's still been many absences that really shouldn't have happened. And I feel like now that we're a big cast, but each part is very fit together. So if we have one piece missing, it's pretty much gonna crumble, and that's gonna be our biggest problem.
I try not to do a ton of nitpicky things during read-through because I really want you to find your character. It's very important to me that you find your character. And then I will work with who you discover, okay? Mm-hmm. Who you create. So because I feel that if I'm giving it to you and I'm giving it to you, it's not organic. It's not really coming from you. You just become then robots repeating what I'm giving you.
Really good rehearsal today, I felt. If we could just move the tables, that would be awesome. Get good night's sleep. Good job, everyone.
Woo!
Is that a boxer?
Thank you.
posters, we do the billboard, which goes outside, and then we also have this big drop cloth thing going down for the bathroom. So we do that too. It's always fun to see like the set come alive once like the actors are on it and stuff.
Hi, I'm Angela. I'm part of Felicity, and pretty much we advertise for the show, and we work the stands during intermission, and we also usher people in and give out flyers for the show. So yeah,
walk a dancer team behind you.
My name is Andrew Jung, and we're in charge of the light board.
And we have hat hair.
And we do the spotlights, and that's it.
Coming into it, I didn't really know too much about the play. I'd never seen it. I'd heard about it because, you know, it's really famous. But yeah, it's, you know, shaping up to be, you know, it looks like it's going to be a good performance. And yeah, I didn't expect it to be this, you know, smooth, and everybody's cooperating really well. And yeah, some really talented people are doing it this year. So.
Because we're such a big cast, it's going to be our managing the people backstage and making sure that they're all quiet. And yeah, because we have such a small stage that, I think that might be our biggest problem. But other than that, everyone is really talented.
I think the biggest problem with this production is definitely going to be finding a way to get 31 people on a stage without bumping into each other. And doing that all by show night should be interesting. So my part as production assistant is working mainly with makeup and wardrobe, and I think the hardest part is going to be getting everybody in costume, makeup for show night. There's so many people, and getting everybody
little
ready,
bed,
it's going to be hard.
Little traveler, I don't understand what's happening today. Everything is all a blur. All I can see is a happy child. The sweet little bird you were, Havalet, Havalet. Little bird, little Havalet, you were always such a pretty little thing, everybody's favorite child. Gentle and kind and affectionate, what a sweet little bird you were, Havalet, Havalet.
Gulda's latch thing snaps. We need a bobby pin back. One of the skirts lost the thread and it's twice its size. I'm not sure how that happened, but you could fit three girls into one skirt model. We need to fix that.
I came here late because of all the traffic, and so we got here like 30 minutes late. Had to walk here. The makeup. Yeah, I remember last year they put on like 5 coats of mascara, so it was even worse than it is now. So I think I'm gonna ask them to tone it down, because I gotta be like a villain, not really beautiful.
Well,
I think today is going to go very well. I hope we all perform our best with these new thoughts. I thank you for being here.
Like, honestly, it's awesome. It's going to be phenomenal. We're having fun. We're doing a good job. A few mess ups here and there, but hey, every mess up before is going to lead to less of a mess up on the stage.
As a musical director, different musicals have, they all have hurdles, and each musical has its own hurdles. This one has, I think, probably the biggest hurdles with Fiddler on the Roof. The thing about which I'm being the most careful are something in musical lingo, we call them vamps. And that's where either a group of people or one person are singing a song, and then they start reciting lines. But while they're reciting lines, the music is still going. And you have to keep playing while they're reciting lines, and then all of a sudden something will go like this. And that has to happen the same way every time. Because when I'm playing the piano, it's very easy for me to make an alteration. If one of the actors changes the way they sing something or changes the tempo of their speech element before they come in, I can adjust to it. It's just me. But at the show, I'm going to be armed with nothing more than a baton and 30 musicians sitting in front of me watching me, and they need to know when to come in. So I have to work that out with the actors. Fiddler on the Roof has a lot of those vamps in it. Singing, and we need to work that out with the singers and between the musical director and the actors so that they not only sing it the same way every time and I conduct it the same way every time, but that their dialogue is in the same tempo every time. So especially in this show, because there's a lot of comedy in it, comedy relies heavily upon timing, and some of the musical cues punch the joke, and so if we don't get it right, we lose the joke. And that's probably the thing that I'm the most concerned about, because it's different.
Okay, so Tech Saturday was really stressful. We were supposed to do a full run-through of everything, but we were only able to go through songs and dancing. So that was pretty stressful because people still need to work on their lines. And I know everyone's trying their hardest, and hopefully we'll be able to pull through for the musical days.
Extremely stressful. Really long day. We have a lot to fix, but you know, I think it's going to work out. It's going to be hard, but it'll work.
I really enjoyed the musical. It was really fun. I got to work with the cast. I got closer to them, but they really need to know how to be responsible with their stuff, which they will learn eventually, and I'm really excited for show nights.
The singing was really, like, it was great.
It was on point.
It was really great, and I think my crew did a really great job. I'm, like, so proud of them, and they took on, like, so many responsibilities that the actors had to do, but it's okay.
I'm Emery Shintani. I'm one of the sound crew heads. Honestly, Tech Saturday was really frustrating because I was missing almost half of my crew, and it's kind of like really messy because we have a lot of actors for the mic. We'll try to manage within the next few rehearsals for the musical.
It was pretty hectic because we changed for different people for the different casts, but it was very fun, especially like when we like helped them get into character with all the stuff. It's really cool.
Yeah, it was really tricky, but a great experience.
Yeah.
As for the show, I'm kind of nervous because we didn't do it flawlessly today, so we don't have many days left before our first performance on Thursday. But I trust this cast, and I think we're going to get it together.
It was really nice, but it was also very... Well, getting into makeup and costume was kind of magical because the characters were coming alive, but, you know, there were lots of, like... There was a lot of craziness, but I'm glad that we got through it and we know what mistakes we're making so we can fix it. So that was good.
I would like to say this musical has definitely changed my life in a good way. I've gotten a new friend group. I've learned to make better connections with people. I learned how to sing. And being in IB and having no time for anything, even though this is stressful, it's a good kind of stress. It helps me relieve other stresses. I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world, and I'm definitely doing it again next year.
Tech Saturday was frustrating. It's always frustrating. It should never not be frustrating, because that's when we learn the most, believe it or not. It's like only a few days before the show, but that's when we really set everything, because we're all finally coming together. And as much as I pick on all the little things, I really love working with this cast, because they accept my little picking and they, you know, I just wish they all had more confidence in their abilities and themselves and would just sort of let things go. And then also with that letting go, also have responsibility for themselves, for each other, for the show. That's the only thing that I find with a high school production is the ownership of the performance. That's the difference between professionals and non-professionals. Professionals feel the ownership, non-professionals do not. And that's where I hope to get the theater, to a place where everyone feels that the show is theirs, you know? I am super happy with all the work we've put in and how well everything is going.
Fiddler on the Roof has always been a favorite of mine. The play has been around for my whole life. It's been on Broadway many times. It very well may be coming back to Broadway next year. It's a wonderful story. It's one of those Broadway shows where the book is wonderful and the music is wonderful. And of course, it was a Jerome Robbins choreographed show, so the dancing is wonderful. There's just no weakness. There's no weak spot in this show. It's funny. It's winsome. It's pensive. And it just has something for everybody. It's a show that you can bring your children to. It has historic value. It's historically accurate. And celebrates life. And that's one of the great songs in this, To Life, L'Chaim. And I think that's what you get from this play, is that life is wonderful. And even when things aren't going your way, or even when you're facing hard times, life can be wonderful. I think that's why I love this play, for all those reasons.